Welcome to the third part of the tutorial. In this tutorial, I will discuss about attention model by using RNN, its architecture and its use in language translation, sequence-to-sequence mapping, and I will also explain how it overcomes the limitations of encoder-decoder model. Finally, I will explain how it overcomes the demerits of encoder-decoder model.
Now, let us start on attention model. Actually, attention model is introduced to overcome the limitations of encoder-decoder model. Here, you can find three identifiable layers. First is encoder layer. Second is attention layer. And third is decoder layer. Actually, in the traditional RNN, we can say that this is input layer node for first layer, this is input layer node for second layer, this is input layer node for third layer, this is hidden layer node, and this is output layer node. In the traditional encoder-decoder model, we generally do not use the output layer node for the entire RNN network. We just use the output layer node for the last node and feed this output to the decoder layer. But in several varieties of attention model, we maintain the output layer node for all the RNN layers in the network. And in some cases, we generally do not maintain the output layer node for any of the RNN layers in the network. Now, the next part is the attention layer. You can find that attention layer also contains the same number of nodes as given in the input layer node. And this attention layer node takes the input from output of encoder layer nodes. All attention layer nodes, for example, here each of the three attention layer node gets the output from all the three outputs from the encoder layer, and it also takes the output from the previous hidden layer node of the decoder network. Now we can understand the decoder network. The decoder network generally gets the input from attention model and then generates the output. Now, how this attention model generally translates something or identify the equivalent sequence for any given sequence. Now, suppose we want to apply some sequence to sequence mapping for three words like machine learning and algo with some other word like X, Y, Z. Means X, Y and Z is a sequence to sequence mapping for the word sequence, machine learning and algorithm. Then how it is possible? For that we can maintain some vocabulary sequences or word vectors like X1, X, X2, like that. That will fade as an input to this hidden layer node. Similarly, Y2, Y, Y1, Y to this, it will fade to this hidden layer node, and similarly for Z2, Z1, Z, and it will fade to this hidden layer node. And then when the encoded signal will come to the attention layer will take the output from this hidden layer, which contains the input from the decoded symbol also, and based on that it will decide that what kind of decoding, whether XY represents the machine and learning or whether this is more powerful and XYZ is the correct representation of machine learning and algorithm, will be decided by this attention layer node and this decoder output. So here this is a very simple example. Now, to get the entire functionality, like how this attention layer node actually works, we will go through some detail. Actually, we expanded this extension, this attention layer node, like here. And from the diagram, it is clear that this attention layer node is getting input from the output of all the three nodes of the encoder layer, like ET minus 1, ET and ET plus 1. Next, it also gets the another input from H dash T minus 1. Here H dash T minus 1 is the hidden layer node just previous to the H dash T or the current recurrent neural network node. So it gets these two outputs, and based on the all the outputs, it applies three parallel computations, and these parallel computations has two different operations. First is it takes the output like E dash T minus 1 and H dash T minus 1. It uses these neuron weights. You can see it looks like a complete 10H net. It is a complete neural network node type of architecture with 10H activation function. So it will take two inputs, H dash T minus 1 from here, E dash ET minus 1 from here. These are the neuron weights. So based on that, it will compute the output of this complete part, and this is denoted by MT minus 1. Now this output will fade to this softmax layer. So this output is represented as ST minus 1, and this is output. To get the softmax output, we will multiply this neuron weight with this output of this layer node, and then this is the output at ST minus 1. Similarly, we will calculate the output at ST here and output ST plus 1 here. And now again, we will use this encoded symbol input and multiply it here. You can see here this multiplication. Again, we will take this ST and ET. This is coming here. So we will multiply it here. Again, we will take this ST plus 1 and multiply it with ET plus 1, which is coming from here. And then we will take the sum of all those things, and then it will represent the attention value. And this attention value will be fed to the hidden layer of decoder network. Now, the hidden layer of the decoder network will get the additional input from the previous hidden layer node. This is same as we generally see in the traditional RNN kind of architecture. It will take another input also, which will be equal to the symbol. If we are using some sequence to sequence mapping or some translation, so it will get some another input also. And based on that, at this layer, we will compute the sigmoid functions for all these inputs. For example, it is ZT into, suppose some neuron weight contains like XZ. So XZ plus this will come. So this is the neuron weight. So W dash T minus 1 into H dash T minus 1 plus some other weight will also come here. Suppose it is like X double dash, and with some neuron weight, suppose we represent is a N dash. So we will fade it, and this will again go through the output layer. So the output layer, suppose we represent it like as out of H dash T. So we will fade this output to the next layer or upper layer. So upper layer output will be like a softmax of UT into out H dash T plus some bias factor if we want. Similarly, we can compute all the outputs, and these outputs probability value will decide that what will be the output symbol for any given input symbol. So we can use this feature in machine translation, sequence to sequence mapping, or in some case as a pattern matching, question answering, summarization. Now, just understand these benefits through some other way. Like in the traditional artificial neural, traditional encoder decoder model, as we have seen in the previous video, that when the encoder passes its symbol, it passes just one part, like probability of xt minus, conditional probability of xt minus 1 given xt and xt minus 1. Compared to that, it passes to other symbols also, to other information also, equivalent language model information also. Like here it will pass the conditional probability of xt given xt minus 1, and it will pass the probability of xt minus 1. So instead of depending upon the last symbol only, we can use the information about each stage of the sequence in the entire computation, and the entire such kind of selection is controlled by this attention layer node. Now you may think that how this attention layer node is getting the input. This is very simple, and we can easily understand that first of all, the input will go to the hidden layer node, and then the computation, just like a simple RNN kind of computation, it will be equal to sigmoid of Vt minus 1 in this case. Again, as it is not getting any input from anywhere, so it will be 0. So just it will be like Vt minus 1 into xt minus 1 plus some bias if it is given. And in this case, it will get the input like sigmoid of xt into Vt plus w. This is a neuron weight, wt minus 1, and it is getting the output from this hidden layer node. So this ht minus 1 output will come here. So we can say that it is like out ht minus 1, and this will be equal to, this entire computation will be equal to out of ht. So this out of ht will go to the output layer node, and here we will compute the softmax of softmax value, and which will be equal to ET softmax of this UT into out of HT plus some bias factor if it is given. Similarly, we can compute all the outputs, and we will feed this output to the upper layer node. There may be some another arrangement also. We can derive a lot of different arrangements to do the same kind of task. For example, additional to this arrangement, we can make a simple, like suppose we have RNN model at encoder layer like this, and these are the source language. Suppose we want to translate like A, B and C to another language like X, Y, another language word like X, Y and Z. So, and these are the source encoder RNN, and these are the target encoder RNN. And in that case, our decoder will contains only three output layer node, and we can put the attention layer node here which will get the input from like this. Now, instead of getting input from here, we will apply some context calculation scheme, and this context will be fed as additional input, and like that, and then it will go to the output here and it will generate the appropriate output. So this is encoder part, this is attention part, this is context generation, and this is decoder part. But one thing is same, that all the attention node at attention layer or attention part has same role to decide that which part of the encoded symbol will go to which other part. So this is a simple RNN layer, it will be computed like this. It is a RNN recurrent layer. This is again, it will be connected like that. So this is RNN recurrent layer. So based on that, we can design any different kind of network for any different task by using this attention model. Now, how to compute the cost of this attention model, where it is costly or very easy to go through. Now we can see that for each of the layer, we have three computation unit. So for three, we have total 3 × 3, 9 computation unit. Suppose we have such 100 input, then it will be 100 × 100, like type of computational cost. So it will be highly computationally expensive for very long sequences. It has some merits but demerits also. Now other thing is, instead of using RNN, we can use the LSTM model also. We can replace this hidden layer node through some LSTM units, and we can easily generate LSTM based attention model. Now one more thing that may be important, like this is the forward pass, like how the input is getting, how the output is generating, and how it takes the input and how it generates the output. Now the next part is how we can train such kind of network. Can we train the entire network one by one or at same time? So the answer is, we train the entire network at the same time, not part by part, just like encoder decoder model. So this is very important to understand. Now other thing is, we have used the following references in preparation of our lecture video, so please go through these papers for further understanding. Thank you.